We can improve the overall hit latency of the cache using a virtually accessed cache. In that case, the virtual address is what we use to access the cache and get the data. On a cache miss, we would use the virtual address to tell us what the physical address is so that we can bring data into our cache. But on cache hits, we can get the data without doing the TLB access at all. So the advantages of this virtually accessed cache over the physically accessed one are that the overall hit time is just the cache hit time with no TLB latency added to it. That's nice. And we don't need the TLB access on cache hit, so we can save energy. We like that too. So we have seen that a virtually accessed cache has the hit time that is just the cache hit time, because we use the virtual address to access the cache. And because of that, we get the data even without address translation on a cache hit, so we can only access the TLB on a miss, which saves us TLB misses and saves energy, which is also nice. So it looks like the virtually accessed cache would win every time. So why are we even considering physically accessed caches? Well, first of all, the TLB, in addition to containing the translation for the physical address, also contains permissions that we need to tell us whether we are allowed to read or write or execute certain pages. So even though we don't need a physical address from the TLB in order to get our data, we still need to access the TLB even on cache hits just to get the permissions that tell us whether we are allowed to read, write, or execute that location. So this advantage really doesn't exist in real processors. A bigger problem is that the virtual address is specific to a particular process. So if we were running one process and filled the cache with its data, once we begin running another process, that other process will have virtual addresses that might overlap with the addresses from the previous process, but they should be going to different data. Pretty much in the TLB, there would be different translations for that other process, and we should be accessing different actual memory locations. Because our cache only knows about virtual addresses in this case, we now need to flush our cache, meaning remove all the data from it, every time we do a context switch. Once we are switching to another process, we know that virtual addresses are going to map to different locations, so what we have to do is get rid of everything we have in the cache. This means that we have a burst of cache misses every time we switch processes. Processes are switched once every millisecond or so it doesn't sound like a big deal. But keep in mind that the cache can be large, so it takes a lot of misses to bring in the data into it. So this is a disadvantage.